हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? प्लीज़ टेक गुड केयर ऑफ़ योर सेल्फ। साइमल्टेनियसली डोंट स्किप योर स्टडीज, कीप स्टडिंग ऑन अ रेगुलर बेसिस। वेलकम बैक इन दिस वीक विद द सेम यूनिट, यूनिट 6, व्हेन यू आर ओल्ड। एंड इन दिस यूनिट सॉरी इन दिस वीक वी आर गोइंग टू read the summary, or maybe I'm going to put the whole theme of the poem in simpler words, easier words for you to understand, as I had told you in the last class. A quick revision and reading of the poem once again. When You Are Old, written by William Butler Yeats. When you are old and gray and full of sleep and nodding by the fire, take down this book and slowly read and dream of the soft look your eyes had once and of their shadows deep. How many loved your moments of glad grace and loved your beauty with love false or true? But one man loved the pilgrim soul in you and loved the sorrows of your changing face. And bending down beside the glowing bars, murmur a little sadly how love fled and paced upon the mountains overhead and hid his face amid a crowd of stars. So the poem When You Are Old is about the speaker's beloved lady. The poet was madly in love with her, but she never responded to his love. Now see, there was one lady who was very, very, very beautiful, and so many young men loved her. But many of them loved her for her physical beauty, that is, her looks, her eyes, her hair, her soft and glowing skin, etc., etc. But only one person, that is the poet, loved her not only for her physical beauty, but also he was madly in love with her holy soul, her nature, her behavior, her thoughts, her inner beauty, that is, her character. But the fact is that a person cannot remain young and beautiful for the whole lifetime, right? A time comes when the body grows old. So, the physical beauty, that is, the looks, the charm, the glow, all this subsides away, fades away, goes away. And then people tend to look much different and, in a way, not so beautiful as they would be in their youth days. So here also, the young lady has gone old now and her face has changed. Her looks have changed. She feels weak, tired and lost. Now the poet wishes that, sitting by the fireplace, when she is old, she should read the book of poems which the poet has written for her and realize that then in the youth days many people loved her only for her physical beauty, but whereas only the poet loved her inner beauty, her soul. In this poem, the poet imagines his beloved lady in the future, that is, when she is old, that she would be sitting by the fireplace and reading the book of poems which he has written for her. He tells her that one day she would become old and her hair would turn gray. She would lose the soft look of her deep eyes. She would feel drowsy and tired all the time. She would spend most of her time by the fireplace, sleeping and warming herself. He wants her to take up the book of poems and read it slowly. By reading the book, she would remember the past, that is, her youthful beauty, and also remember the men who loved her, who admired her. But those other persons loved her physical beauty and grace. But the poet loved her truly, and his love was spiritual. Now, when she is old, and because she doesn't look as beautiful as she was in her youth days, those admirers, those persons who loved her for her physical beauty, have all gone away from her life. So now she feels that she is left alone. That is why she would now feel sad over the fate of the dead poet. Why? Because it was only the poet who loved her nature, her character, her inner beauty, and not her looks. But then she did not respond to his love. She did not care for his love. But now she is repenting over it. That is why he says, true love has fled. Fled means, as I told you in the last class also, fled means gone away. And is hiding his face amid the crowd of stars. He is dead now, he is no more, and probably he has gone and settled down into the crowd of stars. That is what she thinks now. Now, the poet wants the lady to realize the value of that love which she has lost, which has gone away from her. Had the poet been alive till now in the sense when the lady is old, the poet also would be old, right? If they both had been alive, probably he would love her the same way as he loved her in the youth days. But unfortunately, the lady is left alone because the poet is dead, and that is what she has lost. And the poet wants her to realize this fact. The poet is already fearful that she would grow old without him. Thus, the poet speaks of his unfulfilled love. See, here in the poem, the poet is trying to describe the youth days, okay, of a person, how beautiful he or she looks. But as aging starts, that means as we grow in age, we grow older, we start transforming the face, the looks, even the behavior, the emotional level, thought, thinking process, everything goes on altering as we age. So, nothing is permanent. Beauty is also not permanent. What kind of beauty? Physical beauty. The body, the physical appearance of a person does not look the same at all stages of life. When we are very young, we look different. When we are in the youth, we look beautiful, handsome, graceful, adorable, admirable, lovable. Okay. And when we age, the face changes, the looks change, the appearance changes. And along with all these bodily changes, physical changes, even changes takes place in the thinking process. Then the person craves to be with a person who loves the person as he or she is in the old age, not in the youth days. Getting the point? So here the poet goes beyond. The poet goes beyond to the point of one man's death, and the lady being left alone, grieving over him, repenting that the poet is dead now. Bending down beside the glowing bars, as you saw in the picture, sitting by the fireplace, she is all alone now. She would be murmuring sadly how her love fled from the world. As I told you again, it's the same description, that the only person who loved her in her youth days would love her in the same way in the old age also. But what happened? The person to love her is no more now. Love has fled away. Love has gone away. She has lost that love. She would be murmuring sadly how her love fled away from the world. Means the only man who loved her truly was no more now and went to be with the stars in the heaven. So you understand, here the poet is trying to highlight two different contrasts, that is youth and old age, then aging, then time transition. Time doesn't wait for anyone. You are a child today, tomorrow. Tomorrow means not in the literal sense. As you age, you get into your youth, and as you age, you get old. So time doesn't wait. Time keeps on transiting from one phase of life to another. Then what is the poet ultimately trying to suggest by writing this poem? The poet, in a way, is calling upon all of us to develop inner beauty. By means of contrasts, the poet tells us not to boast of the outer beauty, because it fades away, it goes away. Outer beauty disappears after a phase of time, after a certain age. Correct. He tells us not to also mistake infatuation as true love. That is the reason in the very first class when we started this unit, I gave it a bit in detail for you to understand what is infatuation and what is love. I hope you remember. So, the poet is trying to tell us that we should be able to differentiate between infatuation and love. Here in the poem itself, you can see the many persons who loved the lady for her physical beauty, that love was short-lived just for the outer appearance, physical appearance. But so that was infatuation. But the poet loved her behavior, her character, her nature, her inner beauty, her soul. So that was his true love. He tells us not to mistake infatuation as true love. Therefore, we should carefully differentiate between false love, that is infatuation, and true love. Here, he also tries to tell us what our state will be when we grow old, so that we should cultivate that inner beauty which lasts forever. Okay? So I hope the theme of the poem in simple words is clear to you by now. So that is all about the poem When You Are Old. And so we end up unit number 6. So now read the poem once again carefully. Go into deeper thoughts and try to read between the lines so that you understand, and try to summarize all 3 classes of explanation right from the pre-reading activity till the end of this class. And if possible, write all the points down in your notebook and read them again and again, so that will give you a better understanding of the poem. So till then, keep studying. Take care of yourself. Read the poem again. In the next class, we shall discuss question and answers of Unit 6, When You Are Old. Till then, take care. Bye. See you in the next class.